Na dann, herzlich willkommen zu West of Loathing. Wir haben das letzte Mal schon mal kurz reingespielt. Ich werde jetzt aber nochmal von vorne anfangen. Dann gucken wir uns nämlich alles noch ein bisschen mehr in Ruhe an. Bin quasi nochmal ein neuer Charakter. Edit your name. Ja, wollen wir uns selber einen aussuchen haben? Eigentlich hatten wir ja immer irgendwie John McBean. Ich habe immer keine tolle Idee für irgendeinen Namen. Cat Ear. Aus. Sind teilweise irgendwelche bekannten Leute, ne? Ich kenne mal alles nicht, ey. Catherine Pickett? Wir nehmen jetzt Catherine Pickett. Ich habe keine Ahnung. We are ready to get going. Are you? Oh yeah. So, I had the strangest dream. I was choosing a character class. Genau, wir wären entweder Beanslinger, Cowpuncher oder Snake Oiler. Es scheint so ein bisschen zu sein, als ob das irgendwie ein Krieger wäre. Das wäre irgendwie ein Zauberer oder sowas. Oder. Also, Beanslinger, eigentlich sagt man ja blaue Bohnen für Revolverkugeln. Also, vielleicht ist es auch einfach dann ein Fernkämpfer. Der halt hier aber wirklich mit Bohnen schnipst oder sowas. Oder mit Bohnen zaubern kann. Snake Euler scheint irgendwie ein Alchemist oder sowas zu sein. Was auch irgendwie interessant sein kann. Wir nehmen mal einen Alchemisten. Snake Oilers rely on their moxie and should spar to tame snakes. Their fearlessness to extract potent oils from those snakes and their cleverness to manufacture and sell potions made from those oils. You heard Snake Oilers are doing really well out west since the cows came home. Everybody needs potions and hope in these dark days. And also out west is where all the best snakes live. I wanna be a Snake Oiler! Genau, und da sind wir nun. Genau, wir können das ein- und ausblenden. Ich weiß nicht genau, was das war, ob das dann die Währung gleich ist. Genau, wir haben jetzt unseren Charakter, Catherine Pickett, Snake Oiler, Stomach, how many food items you can eat before you need a nap. Okay. Only go to sleep for an entire night. Liver, how many alcoholic drinks you can handle. Spleen capacity determines how many potions you can use in a day. HP. Being knocked unconscious means you lose whatever fight you're in, as far as you know. Speed, who goes first in combat? The West may be brutal, but it is fair. Range damage bonus? Pistol attacks, okay, dann haben wir hier Muscle. Achso, dann steht jetzt hier nochmal. How beefy you are. How much damage you do. How much damage you take. Physicality. Amount of damage you do with spells. Amount of damage you take from spells. Elemental attacks from bad guys. Moxie. You've got Moxie, kid. How much damage you deal with when shooting and how much damage you take when getting shot. Das ist irgendwie krass, dass es auch gleichzeitig immer dann der Verteidigungswert anscheinend ist. The extent of which you are truly gritty. The higher it is, the tougher you'll be. Pain tolerance. How angry you can get before you pass out. Gumption? Get up or get it done. The quicker you are, the glamour, consume more cocktails, you'll be able to afford them. Okay, also das sind anscheinend die Sachen, die dann von meiner Klasse irgendwie kommen. Grit, Gumption und Glamour. Der Klicksound ist irgendwie komisch. Okay, und wir haben noch zwei Mystic Skills. Deadeye, Crackshot. You can bullseye at 300 paces. You can shoot a fish in a barrel, even if the fish is really small and the barrel is really big. Okay. Also es gibt uns Bonusschaden für Pistolen. Horns Woggling. You're a city slicker and the witty trickster. Okay. Combat Skills. Snake Whip. About a snake, then whip something with it. Flat amount of damage and poisons the target. Okay. HP Cost? Kosten die auch HP? Nee. Das ist quasi anscheinend passiv. Das sind dann aktive Skills, die HP kosten. What good is a briefcase full of snakes if you can't occasionally pull a snake out and tell it what to do? Summons a baby snake? Summons an adolescent snake. Okay. Goodbye, bed. Time to head west to chase my real dreams. Goodbye, desk. Comb hair. You comb your hair one last time. You gain 1 XP. Okay. This weird poster appeared here one night. You read the spine of one of your books, The Adventure of Witch Church. Rufus liked this one as much as I did. Ah, hier kommen irgendwie 1000 Büchernamen. Oh, hey, this one might come in handy. You got an item, Walking Stupid. Okay, wir gehen mal ins Inventar. Yeah, gear. No hat, no lapel, no pistol, no weapon, no offhand ring, no pants, no boots. Das ist nicht so viel. Walking Stupid. This book tells the tale of a renegade sheriff who was really, really bad at walking. Unlock stupid walking as an option. You read the book from cover to cover and learn how to walk really stupidly. Stupid walking has been added to your options menu. You got a perk. Stupid walking. Nice. You accidentally drop the book and then ruin it by stepping on it 30 times while you're trying to pick it up. Oops. Okay, in welchem Ansatz ins Menü gehen? Stupid walking! Und some of them aren't even really walks. Ich mach das mal wieder aus. Gibt's hier noch was, wenn wir noch mehr Bücher lesen? Nee. Goodbye, phonograph. Turned off. You pull the handle away from the cylinder and stow the handle away. Haben wir es jetzt? Nee. Wir lassen die Musik mal noch ein bisschen spielen. Hey Russell, how you doing? Caw. Gonna miss you, buddy. Feed Russell the cricket. You grab a cricket from your cricket bag and feed it to Russell. He coos appreciatively and nuzzles your hand. Goodbye, Russell. Be good. On the head right today. What a mess. Stack firewood. You gain 1 XP. This hearth really puts the hearth in hearth at home. Gonna miss mom's cooking. You miss meals with the family. It's mom's pie safe. It keeps all her pies safe. Little brother's room. One of your brother's weird books and flips through it in the investigation of the laws of thought, on which are founded the mathematical theories of logic and probabilities. Just a little page gives me a headache. And just the title page gives me a headache, okay. Okay, wir kriegen aber da irgendwie immer Mathematikbücher. I wonder I never know what he's talking about. Okay, irgendwas auf Latein. Okay, hier sind anscheinend immer nur random Bücher, die wir nicht verstehen. It's a Kid Brothers Toy Box, look inside. Hey, he loves stuff like this. You got an item puzzle cube. So, tidy. Puzzle cube. This is one of your kid brother's weird puzzles. Fiddle with it. Your brother already had it most of the way solved, but you figure out the last couple of moves. 1 XP. Hooray! You've already solved it, and if you mess it up again, it'll be messed up forever. Oh yeah. Your family's farm. No time to screw around in the woods. Time to head west. Your mom smiles warmly as you approach. I'm leaving now, mom. We're gonna miss you, kiddo. Oh, and before you leave, I got you a present. Present? Yep, it's a book you wanted for Crimbo. I know it's early, but the one about picking locks, the one about desert survival, about bartering. Ach, ich weiß nicht, was davon am besten ist. Wir machen am Picking Locks. That's the one, enjoy it. Got an item, locks and how to pick them. Please be careful out there. Write us a letter when you can. She hugs you. I will, mom. Goodbye. This book is a comprehensive guide to advanced lockpicking techniques. I've got a whole chapter on Tumblr. It's got a whole chapter on Tumblrs. Gives you the lockpicking expertise skill. Read it. You quickly memorize the entire book. They ain't yet invented a lock that'll keep you out. You can pick complex locks. Nice. After you're done reading it, you donate it to a local orphanage. Soon those orphans will be able to make their escape. Go orphans, go. Sehr schön. Your father morosely jabs at the haystack. That hat doesn't fit you, Dad. I grow into it. It's time for me to leave. Listen, I want you to have this. It's your grandmother's briefcase full of snakes. He got an item, briefcase full of snakes. Thank him. Thanks, Dad. Good. Good luck out there. Be sure to say goodbye to your mother. I did. Goodbye, Dad. He's just barely holding it together. It's probably best for him if you just go. Oh, this is the briefcase you keep your favorite snakes in. Venom level 3, medicine level 3. Look inside. Extract some venom, extract some medicine, close the briefcase. Ja, machen sie jetzt so. Kann man ja jederzeit irgendwie speichern oder so und dann was ausprobieren? Nee. Ich probiere mal einfach, extract some venom. You grab a bottle and squeeze some snake venom into it. You got an item, basic venom vial. Machen wir mit Medicine. Weiß ich nicht, wir könnten die natürlich jetzt einfach irgendwie alle machen. Keine Ahnung, ob das besser ist. It's a haystack. Dig through it. Hey, a needle. Got an item, needle. It's not for sewing, it's for picking locks. Okay, dann haben wir ja das perfekte Buch dafür. Your brother Rufus is standing here looking nervous. He's pretty good at looking nervous. Give him his puzzle back. You hand him the puzzle and he starts fidgeting with it. Say goodbye. Hey Rufus, time for me to head west. I still don't understand why you're leaving. He's got a point, you know. Why are you going west anyway? To help people to seek my fortune. To get out of the stupid farm. To seek my fortune. There's just no opportunity here, kid. If I'm gonna make something of myself, I gotta go where I can make some meat. But it's so dangerous. 60% of the people who go west get killed within a year. And that statistic is from before the cows became home. Came home. It'll be okay. Okay, if you say so. I still think you'll be dead by Crimbo. I'll miss you, Rufus. Okay. I'll give him a playful punch on the arm. Leave. Okay. Go West, Young Woman.
Yes.
Können eigentlich nicht so viele sein. Kann sein, dass immer selber das steht? Dialect Coach? What?
Zieh mal den Tisch gerade noch mal ein bisschen näher an mich ran.
Ich dachte schon, wir fahren jetzt zu weit. Das hätte ich auch witzig gefunden. Well, the bad news is that you fell off the cart and got knocked out for a couple of hours and now you've got no ride, no meat and no prospects. The good news is that you're in a town rather than in a gulch somewhere. Not much of a town though. Get up and dust yourself off. Ouch! A turnip! Get turnip. A turnip! You've got an item. Dusty turnip. Ist er? Pick! Yikes! 300 miles is too far to go on foot. You need a horse. Okay. Turnip? Dusty turnip. A turnip covered in grit. Increase your muscle, mysticality and moxie by 1 for the rest of the day. Chunk of wood from the broken hitching post. Grab it. Got an item. Broken board. Wir haben eine Waffe. Speak softly and carry a crude stick. Damage 3 to 4. BS horsery. A sign on the door reads, gun drinking. Okay. Yuck. Yuck. Up in die Bar. As you walk into the saloon, the crazy-eyed guy sitting to the left of the floor shrieks and waves at you to get your attention. Hey, where's your hat, Dagnabit? Well, I can't drink in here without a hat. Ain't proper. He points to a take-a-hat-leave-a-hat box next to the door. Check out the box. You look through the hat box and find a battered derby. That looks like something you'd wear. Grab it. You got an item, floppy derby. You grab the hat and put it on. Thanks, Pete. Thanks, Pete. He gives you a friendly, if somewhat twitchy nod. Say, gal. Yeah? You're heading west? If you want some company, I'd be more than happy to come along. Just let me know. Well, no pressure. Alright, I keep it in mind. Okay, also wir haben direkt einen Hut bekommen und es will ja direkt einer mitkommen. Wir haben diesen Floppy Derby plus one Moxie. Okay. Okay, gehen wir mal raus. Ich dachte, der kommt noch. You already have a hat. What would you do with two? You should probably leave him alone. It's locked. Pick the lock. Weiß nicht, ob das cool ist, wenn wir einfach überall einbrechen. Nur weil wir es können. A pile of old newspapers. Take one. Got an item. Boring Springs Gazette. 20. April 1895. This is a copy of the Boring Springs newspaper from about 6 weeks ago. Okay. The goblin shouts Briark. Attack the goblin? Crate of Nurse Brand Whiskey. Good for what ails ya. I guess we never established your age. Good thing the legal drinking age here is can reach the top of the bar. You got an item. Nurse Brand Whiskey. Ja, dann würde ich sagen, kämpfen wir gleich gegen den, oder? Mal ausprobieren, wie das funktioniert. This whiskey is too cheap for you to even consider drinking it. And given your legendarily low standards, that's really saying something. Dann. So, Sekunde. Dann würde ich sagen, greifen wir den mal an, oder? Got to jump on them. Shoot, Spacebar, Skills. Okay, wir haben ein Action Point. Whip it. Das kostet jetzt 1 AP. 5 Damage, 1 Poison. Deploy Snake. Pull a Snake, deploy on side of the battlefield. Würde ich gleich mal machen, oder? Dann haben wir die Schlange beschworen. Voll gut. Dann würde ich jetzt mit dem Reli-Attack zuhören. Die Schlange macht 5, will man nur 3. Und sie blockt uns. Voll gut. Die Frage ist, wie wir AP generieren, ne? Können wir eigentlich hier noch eine Option machen im Kampf? Vielleicht noch was Neues? Nerd Mode, schon Combat Grid. Allows the game to level up your skills for your attempt to create a wear-on character. Ist vielleicht jetzt beim ersten Mal spielen nicht so schlecht. Mich nervt so eine Fliege. Mach eine Biege. Victory! Skill up, Moxie Level 2. Having dispatched the goblin, you pat yourself on the back for a job. Well done! Back upstairs. The woman glares at you, you should probably just let her drink. Howdy, I'm Catherine. Howdy, Catherine, I'm Horace. Nice to meet you. What do you do? I'm the town hostler. I don't know what that is. I'm the town horse selling guy. Gotcha. How's that working out for you? Oh, those horses are just flying out the door. So business booming? Nice. No, I mean the horse keep running away. I haven't sold one in ages. Oh, is that why you're here drinking instead? Yep. And me being in here drinking instead of watching the horses is probably how they keep escaping. It's one of those vicious circle things. Well, I'm in need of a horse. Do you have any left? One. Kind of a boring one, but it's got 4 legs and a back to sit on. Come see at me at the stables. Stable. I'll be happy to show it to you. Okay. Das klingt gut. You walk up on the bar and wait patiently for the bartender to notice you. While you're waiting, you see a sign taped on the back wall reading, reward for lost marks, 25 meat each. Keep waiting. The bartender finally notices you. Howdy cowgirl, howdy barkeep, name's Catherine. What keeps you to our little backwater? That's about work. Oh, the usual. I came out west to make my fortune. Not having much luck so far, though. Any work around these parts? Unfortunately, Boring Springs already has more people in it than jobs. It's more of an errand town, if you catch my meaning. If you're looking for a real job, I'd recommend talking to the railroad people up by Dirtwater. Okay, fragen nach Railroad. The Railroad? The Manifest Destiny Railroad Company, from back east. They're trying to run a line in Frisco, and having a heck of a time doing so. And they're hiring? Oh, I reckon they're always hiring for one thing or another. Big company that. Dirtwater? Dirtwater is interesting. It's far enough west that it's still more or less exempt from the rule of law, but not so far west that it's been burned to the ground by the damned cows. Lots of opportunity there. She paused for a few seconds, lost in thought. Yep. If I were a younger woman, I'd probably head that way myself. You mentioned errands? Yeah, this Forsaken Burg is always falling apart in one way or another. The hostler's always needing help since he hurt his leg, and that no account sheriff could certainly stand to have somebody doing his job for him. Anything else? Well, I've got a goblin loose in the basement. Some cowpoke in from the gulch didn't wipe his boots off and got spores everywhere. I already took care of that goblin. Thank you kindly, Catherine. I knew it was a stand-up gal the moment you walked in here. She paused for a moment. Though I could have sworn the door to the basement was locked. Guess I must have forgot. She reached under the bar and grabs a bag of meat. Here you go. It's the least I can do by way of thanks. Gain 200 meat. Tip your hat. You tip your hat to the bartender. Who's the lady drinking whiskey out of a beer mug? That's Susie. She's a rancher from nearby. A real tough broad. I ain't recommend you pester her. What's that? Lost a whole family to a cow attack recently. Got some pent-up frustrations about it. The woman glares at you. Howdy, Susie. Howdy, cowgirl. Who's gonna be searching the spittoon for her teeth if she didn't leave me in peace? Okay, bye-bye then. It's a spittoon. People spit into it. You know without even looking in it that it's absolutely disgusting. Look in it. Yeah, it's full of spit. Regular spit, gross tobacco spit, chewing gum, and it looks like a few teeth as well. It's disgusting. And the smell, even from a distance, it smells horrible. Closer. You're now on your hands and knees, peering into a filth and crusted spittoon. I don't understand what's wrong with you. Wait, is there something shiny at the bottom? You reach your hand towards the spittoon. Even before you touch it, you can feel the grossness in the air, like a greasy fog enveloping the stinking brass horror. It smells like the vomits through a mesquite barbecue eating contest. Hesitate. You plunge your hand into the awful soup. It makes a sound like glop. Your skin is burning and eyes start to water. Your fingers make contact with something. You pull your hand out of the devil's tureen, slowly, not daring to risk splashing the contents all over yourself. You appear to have gotten some kind of ring, probably some kind of disease as well. Congratulations, you got an item, nasty ring. Though getting this ring was traumatic, you have to admit that it was worth it. Plus one muscle, plus one mysticality, plus one moxie. Was ziemlich viel ist, wenn man sich überlegt, wir hatten bisher jeweils nur eins und jetzt sind wir bei 2, 2, 4. Ach, Lockpicking ist jetzt so ein richtiger weiterer Skill, den man noch weiter hochleveln kann. Aber gut. Perks, stupid walking. These two are playing poker, or at least try to. They keep looking back and forth from their hands to the how to play poker card that came with their deck, biting their lips and concentrating real hard. Can I play? They look at you nervously. Ach, das ist doch so ein Trick, die sind schon richtig gut. You put 20 meat on the table and sit down before they can say no. One of them shuffles the card sloppily and deals a new round. You get a pair of tens, plus a two, a three, and a king. Weiß nicht, wie das jetzt funktioniert mit Moxie 2, Moxie 3. Schon ziemlich gut eigentlich. Ich mach mal Bet aggressively. Yeehaw, I bet 15 meat. They look at each other nervously and they both call your bet. Pay Redem and Weep. You show your pair of tens plus 2-3 kings. The guy on the left has a full house and the girl on the right somehow got a straight flush. Hornswoggle them. You explain that jacks are worth 9 points each, giving the guy on the left a total of 21 points and the girl on the right 20, and you're 25 plus the king. And the king represents, oh hey, look over there. They look, and when they look back, they don't notice the 10 meat missing from each of their piles. You collect your winnings and stand up. And thank you for helping them learn the game. So, der wollte mitkommen? What do you say, Pete? Who? Me? Well, heck. I say all kind of things. For instance, I've been mining these mountains long and slam jammer raccoon can count the stars. Uh-huh. Pete takes a swig of his whiskey. See you later, Pete. Okay. Vielleicht wollte er auch noch nicht mitkommen, sondern erzählt einfach nur irgendwas. Dann gehen wir mal zum Sheriff. There's a dirty muck here. Grab it. Ja, der hat ja gesagt, wenn wir die zurückgeben, dann gibt's da Kohle für. A dirty glass mug. The bottom is stamped property of Boring Spring Saloon revert. Reward if returned. Howdy, stranger. Welcome to Boring Springs. I'm the sheriff in these parts. The what? The sheriff, okay? Blessed sign painters. Say you won't happen to be looking for work, would ya? As a matter of fact, I am. Great, cause I happen to have some. There's a gang of hoodlums around here what call themselves the Fricker Gang. Last time I arrested one of them, they busted him out and took my cell door with them. It ain't, well, it ain't much good without the door. And? I need somebody tough, smart, and or slick to go fetch it back for me. Why don't you do it? You're the sheriff after all. Okay, I'll give it a shot. Funny you should say that, cause I'm sending the deputy along with you. Keep you out of trouble. He takes a pistol out of stairs and hands it to you. You got an item, deputy pistol. Deputy? You deputinize the gun? You're new in town, maybe you ain't noticed, but there ain't much to do here except drink. Here, let me write down where the Fricker Gang's hideout is for you. He makes a little note on your map and discovered a new map location, the Fricker Gang's hideout. Got it. I'll be back with the door. Wanted for bird theft. Naked Mike Bernstein. 20 meat. Poster artist. Apply in person at the Yuma Marshal's office. Okay. Dann gehen wir da gleich hin und versuchen die Tür wieder zu kriegen. Jetzt die Deputy Pistol. Steht hier eigentlich, ob wir direkt wieder... Anscheinend haben wir jeden Kampf dann NAP, oder wie funktioniert das? AP 1. Action Points are restored before every... okay, also wir haben jeden Kampf quasi einen. Step right up, Braid's the name and trade the game. You seriously doubt that his name is Braid. Howdy. What are you trading? Well, madam, today I'm tracking locks for soap and a stick of dynamite for a needle. And to the cunning skinner who brings me 3 rattlesnakes hides, well, to the adventurous soul I will trade a fine silver pocket watch. Is this soap for a log? Some freed. Okay. Try stickering, try soap. Okay. No trades right now, thanks! Haha! You approach the weird Cactus Man hybrid. He smiles at you. Howdy, Cactus Man. Howdy yourself. The name's Bill. Cactus Bill. What happened to you, Bill? Well, to be honest, partner, I drank too much cactus beer and it turned me into the cactus. Doc Ellis warned me this would happen, but I didn't listen. And what? That's why they call you Cactus Bill? No, that's just a coincidence. Oh, does it hurt? Does what hurt? You know, being a cactus? Oh, haha. No, it's actually kinda nice. The natural fermentation process inside the cactus part of me keep me pretty drunk most of the time. I guess it is might boring. Yeah, I bet. It wouldn't be so bad if I had something to read. You don't happen to have a newspaper or anything, do you? The newspaper? Give him the newspaper you found in the basement of the saloon. Much obliged, partner. Now, let me see what I can do to return your favor. Oh, I know, my shovel. I left it behind the outhouse at Allhole Mine. It's yours if you go and get it. I'm sure you'll find use for it. In the outhouse at Allhole Mine, okay? Behind the outhouse of Allhole Mine? Got it, thanks, Bill. Don't mention it. Now, if you could just kinda stick that newspaper to my face before you leave. You're not allowed in Topeka anymore, remember? Get lost. So, dann können wir den jetzt beim Horsery nochmal fragen. It's a haystack. Dig through it. A needle. Okay, wir finden anscheinend immer eine Nadel, wenn wir da drin suchen. Wir brauchen anscheinend für jedes Log eine neue Nadel. Wahrscheinlich ist es auch für die Sonne. Keine Ahnung. This is the most typical horse you've ever seen. Afternoon, ma'am. What can I do for you? What's business? Oh, you know, every day I'm hustling. To tell you the truth, though, it's pretty terrible. All of my horses keep running away. Well, except of this completely ordinary one. That's rough. Maybe I can help? Oh god, yes, thank you, please. I'd go fetch them myself, except for this injury. I give you 300 meat each for finding them. How many are there? 3. Here, let me see your map. They pretty much always run away to the same places. Allhole Mine, Boring Springs Boneyard, and Thousand Snakes Gulch. Why these places? I think they like environments that are thematically appropriate. Here, when you find one, feed it some of these oats. That should send it back here. Bag of homing oats? How does that work? They are special pigeon-infused oats. Okay. Can you sell me a horse? Sure thing. I should warn you though, horses are mighty attached to their riders. Once you've bought one, you won't be able to change your mind later. Right now I only have the one horse available. Sounds fine to me. Cost 1000. Okay. I busted my knee while mucking out the mushroom. Don't ask how, it's embarrassing. She just shut herself up in her office. Nurse whiskey, okay. Okay. So, dann haben wir noch mehr Orte, zu denen wir gehen können. Wir haben die Homing Oats. Okay. Hey, Tobe! Ach, schön! Ich hoffe, die gefällt dir und passt. Dieses Spiel ist, weiß ich nicht, es ist super strange. Ich habe gerade erst angefangen, aber es ist echt super lustig. Es ist so ein bisschen Paper Mario mäßig. Oder so ein bisschen wie South Park Stick of Truth. Ja, wir haben jetzt auf jeden Fall wir haben verschiedene Aufgaben bekommen. Wir sind gerade in Boring Springs. Es gibt eine Bande, die vom Sheriff die Gefängnistür geklaut hat. Ich glaube, da gehe ich jetzt zuerst mal hin und versuche die wieder zu holen. Ja, muss man probieren. Das, wo es so gebeult ist, das ist halt immer oben, ne? Ich habe hier noch eine, das ist die, die ich heute auf hatte. Ich hoffe, mal keiner irgendwann zieht. Aber du hast quasi so oben nochmal so eine Delle und das ist dann quasi oben. Da ist auch so ein Draht drin, damit die hält. Und dann halt so. Du musst halt sehen, dass du das, den Draht relativ dicht an die Nase oben drückst und dann sollte die gut halten. Das ist halt besonders, ich weiß nicht, ob du eine Brille trägst, aber bei mir ist, oder bei Brillenträgern ist es halt besonders wichtig, damit, wenn man ausatmet, die Brille nicht beschlägt, sondern die Luft nach vorne oder nach unten weggeht und nicht nach oben. Fat Fricker, the Fricker Gang's intrepid lookout appears to be taking a little nap. Oh, wake him up, just shoot him, ignore him. Okay. Ich weiß nicht, das ist jetzt von der bösen Bande der Späher anscheinend. Sollen wir den wecken oder ihn einfach schießen? Wir wecken ihn mal, wir sind nett. You poke Fat with your boot, he slowly gets to his feet. Hey, you're not supposed to be here. Thought is, well, let's say he's no Rhodes Scholar. If we assume that it's 7 years from now and that idiom makes sense, you feel bad about the idea of killing him. Walk away, Thought. Thought, you don't want this life. Take a hike. Okay, you're probably right. Stumbles off into the desert, he'd probably be fine. You got a perk, honorable. Wir haben zwei Perks. Wir haben Stupid Walking und wir haben Honorable jetzt. A strong Moral Compass and Accurate Ethical Protector. Options will be available in some situations. Ah, okay. Wenn wir, wir haben Stupid Walking, das kann man hier einschalten und dann laufen wir immer ganz eigenartig. Das ändert sich auch dauernd. Und sie haben einen blöden Witz gemacht mit Horse Armor DLC. Also ich nehme an, dass sie das meinen, das ist eine was war das? Skyrim? Nee, Oblivion-Anspielung ist, ne? Protects your horse won't actually show up or disappear when toggled until you travel to a new area because we added this dumb joke on the last minute. Colorblind Mode, you never know. Best font mode. Changes the typeface of the game to Arial. Please don't do this. It's a beer barrel cactus. Okay, requires foraging. It's a pile of random stuff the Fricker Gang stole. Find us keepers. Meat ist irgendwie die Währung hier. Got a new item, recovered mug. Das kann man anscheinend in einer Bar zurückgeben. Pair of silver cufflinks. If you wear fancier shirts, you might have use for these. Okay. Okay, da ist anscheinend die Höhle der Gang. Ach, Monty Python-Referenz. Ah, das kann ich nicht. Ich glaube, hier sind so viele Gags drin. Ich glaube, ich verstehe die Hälfte nicht. One of the Fricker Boys is dozing in the bathtub. Can you pass the soda? He mumbles and hands you a bar of soap before sinking deeper into both sleep and the tub. Es gibt so einen Handelpost in der Stadt und der will wirklich handeln. Der will nur Dinge tauschen und nicht irgendwie kaufen, verkaufen. Und der wollte Seife haben. You cautiously approach the Fricker Gang. They're pretty engrossed in their poker game. So it doesn't actually require that much caution. You hide behind a barrel and eavesdrop on their conversation for a while.
The one with the eye patch is quiet, but together that his name is Snipe. And that the squirrel one is his brother Wimpy. What's your play here? Approach them and talk? Ja, komm. Howdy, boys. Dilmian? The one without the eye patch raises an eyebrow at you. Who are you? How'd you get past Thud and Soapy? What do you want? You're under arrest? It's Bimmy? I'm here for the sheriff's door? I'll show you the door. The door to hell! He reaches for his gun. Okay then, fight it is. So, wir haben verschiedene Möglichkeiten. Wir können, wir haben nur einen AP jeden Kampf und wir können mit unserer AP eine Schlange beschwören. A sturdy barrel providing cover. Ah, das sind hier so verschiedene Orte, Plätze. Ich beschwöre dann erst noch wieder eine Schlange. Mit unserem einzigen Action Point. So viel zu dem Fass. So, und dann können wir jetzt entweder zuhören oder schießen. Da schießen mehr Damage macht, würde ich sagen, schießen wir. Der hat 20 HP, der hat noch 5. Von daher würde ich jetzt auf den schießen. The leaders of the Fricker gang are dead by your hand. The sheriff will be proud of you, though you're not sure how your mother would feel. Yeehaw, skill up, Glamour level 2. It increases you'll be able to consume more cocktails and you'll also be able to fort them. Plus 1 liver capacity. Okay. Wir haben alle, die Stats hier sind total strange. Du hast irgendwie Stomach, du hast Liver und du hast Spleen. Stomach ist, wie viel Essen du essen kannst, bevor du die Mittagsschlaf machen oder ein Nickerchen machen musst. Die drei Special Skills, die wir haben, sind Grit, Gumption und Glamour. The extent of which you are truly gritty, the higher it is, the tougher you'll be. Es ist alles sehr strange. Und achso, die Seife war jetzt noch neu. Dr. Swackleton's Pure Castile Soap. Where this comes from, they call it soap. Sein es lauter geworden ist jetzt? Ich habe es alles schon sehr leise gestellt, aber das war jetzt auch immer wieder ein bisschen lauter. There's a mug on the table. Okay. A pile of Frickers ill-gotten grains. What a haul! 50 meat. It's the sheriff's door! A door from the Boring Springs Jail's only cell. Das Spiel ist wohl auch nicht besonders lang. Also ich hatte irgendwie gelesen, dass man so, wenn man nur die Main Story spielt, so 8 Stunden braucht, wenn man alles spielt, so 12. Und naja, solange es nicht langweilig wird, finde ich das sehr, sehr, sehr cool. Dann gehen wir erstmal zurück und bringen die Tür weg. Achso, und wir können auch die ganzen in der Bar mal unsere ganzen gefundenen Gläser abgeben. I found these mugs. Much obliged. I see the Fricker gang hasn't put a stop to your breathing. Did you rescue my cell door? You hand the sheriff his door and he hangs it back on its hinges. Nice work, stranger.
This here prison cell just got about 4 times more secure. Are there any Fricker boys left for me to round up? Yeah, 1 or 2 that are asleep on the job. I'll go round them up shortly then. Looks like I owe you any reward. Got another little task for ya, if you got the time. Should be a lot simpler than the last one. What you need? Well, the Frickers busted the lock when they took the door. Gonna need a new lock. Ach genau, und der eine hat will das tauschen. Ich glaube gegen die Seife, ne? Braid's the name and trade's the game. You seriously doubt that his name is Braid. Genau, locks for soap and a stick of dynamite for a needle. I'll trade this soap for a lock. Braid, though you really don't think his name is actually Braid, takes your soap and hands you a lock. Ja, man kann auch irgendwie bitten um free dynamite, requires dickering. Ich glaube, so rumnerven. Aber wir können auch Dynamit dann gegen eine Nadel tauschen. Ah, wobei, wir können mit den Nadeln halt Schlösser knacken und Dynamit ist dann wahrscheinlich ein Item, um was zu sprengen oder so. Wir lassen das erstmal. Behalten mal die Nadeln. Das ist wohl irgendwie der Arzt oder die Ärztin. Die hat irgendwie einfach zugemacht und die sagt, ruft dann immer nur Get Lost. Ach, wir haben Whisky. Wir können Whisky mal anbieten. Whisky Delivery for you, Dog. What brand? Nurse Whisky. Your favorite, I'm led to believe. Didn't know she makes house calls. Alright, hold on. You hear rattle as she unlocks the door. Dog Alice looks to be about in her 50s. Her hair is graying and her face is lined, but her eyes are still clear and sharp, if bloodshot. She holds out her hand. Whiskey, stat. Give it to her. She cracks open the whiskey and fills a small flask she takes out of her pocket. Then she puts the flask back in her pocket and starts chugging out of the bottle. Jeez, Dog, that doesn't seem healthy. Who's the doctor here, me or you? Okay, point taken. Is everything alright? That depends on how fast I can get this whiskey into my bloodstream compared to how fast my liver filters it out. And I can't talk and drink at the same time, so... She glares at you meaningfully. So what's the matter, Dog? What's the matter? The whole world's gone to hell in a horse cart and you asked what's the matter? Bandits, cow demons, dead men walking. Why don't you go ahead and pick one and I'll drink to that. Dead man walking? You haven't seen it? Corpses and skeletons staggering around like puppets and with half their strings cut, looking to take a bite out of the living? Nope. Well, just count your lucky stars and stay out of the town cemetery then. Ach, da wollten wir als nächstes hin. This vanity doesn't look like it sees much use. Green little? You grab a pair of tweezers and pluck some of your more unsightly eyebrows. You gain 1 XP. Yeehaw! Can look at your books. You should try being less cheerful, Doc. There are all medical textbooks except for a few. Legend of Curly's Mead. Life and Works of Fred Ferguson. Primer. Make like a tree and leave. Tells the story of a legendary treasure, a massive chest full of premium meat, secreted in the western desert by an old cowhand named Curly Butterfield. Civil War Surgeon's Autobiography. Mostly just find lists of reasons that drinking alcohol is bad, so it's actually a work of ludicrous speculative fiction. At least there are some useful appendices on the back, and some diagrams of appendices. You start flipping through the Goblin language book. It's confusing at first, but you eventually get so engrossed that by the time you take a break from reading, several blurfs have passed, and you also know that blurf is a goblin word for hour. You have learned to speak goblin, sort of. Got a perk? Goblin tongue. You can communicate with goblins. At least to order a beer. Ja, es geht hauptsächlich um Alkohol in diesem Spiel. Stuff is spotless. Either she's really compulsive about cleaning or she never cooks. Shouldn't this be further away from the fireplace? Na gut. Dead Man Walking, wir wollten eh zu dem Cemetery, da können wir gleich mal hin. The padlock got its name because it's like a wizard that protects your house. Lock. Achso, Warlock, Padlock. Ah. So, wo ist denn der Sheriff? How do you manage to scare up a lock for my cell? Yep, got one right here. That'll do nicely. Accidentally drops the key and it clatters into the cell. Hellfire! Don't suppose you know how to pick a lock, stranger? You got a needle handy? Okay, jetzt müssen wir das Ding wieder aufknacken. You deftly picked the lock. You've unlocked the cell door. Better let the sheriff reclaim the key himself. So he has something to do today. I unlocked a cell for you. The sheriff walks into the cell and picks up the lock. He looks around for a place to hide it and eventually sticks it under his head. Thank you kindly, stranger. If Boring Springs ever get any more criminals, they'd better watch out. That's a good job you done. Don't mention it. Here, have this as a souvenir of your time of Boring Springs. Replica sheriff badge. Mhm. Ach, hab ich jetzt an. Plus one armor. This is a plastic facsimile of the sheriff's badge. He usually gives them to children who tour the jail. Das sah irgendwie gerade komisch aus. Okay. Ich weiß nicht genau warum, aber jetzt läuft das Spiel nur noch in 30 Frames, nicht mehr in 60. Es ist zu aufwendig. Der Rechner gibt einfach auf. Jetzt sind es wieder 60. Sind es wieder 30. Sind es wieder 60. Keine Ahnung. So, wir haben noch ganz viele Orte, wo wir hingehen. Haben wir davon noch? Pair of Silver Kaffee, könnte denn das hinkommen? Ja, ja. Aber in dem Spiel kann ich nicht viel einstellen. Aber das ist hier das klassische V-Sync. Aber es... Nein, 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 nein. Gut. Aber ich kann mir beim besten Willen nicht vorstellen, dass es nicht in 60 läuft. Hier habe ich aber keins ein- oder ausgestellt. Hier ist es standardmäßig drin. So. Genau, und unsere Hauptaufgabe ist, dass wir mindestens 1000 Miet kriegen, weil dann können wir uns ein Pferd leisten. Und ihm sind 3 Pferde weggelaufen und die sollen wir zurückbringen. Dafür kriegen wir auch jeweils Kohle. Und die sind genau bei diesen 3 Orten. Ach so, das ist Forst quasi. Ja, ich habe da meistens drin, dass das Programm das entscheiden soll. Ich glaube, da habe ich jetzt nichts an. Aber ich weiß auch nicht, ob das manche Spiele nicht auch überschreiben. This is where Bill said to look. Ach genau, das ist der Kaktusmann, den wir in der Zeitung gegeben haben und der sagte, dass wir dahinter nach einer Schaufel gucken sollen. Hey, wasn't kidding. Now that this would have been a funny thing to kid about, I guess. Okay. Weiß noch nicht, was wir mit einer Schaufel sollen, aber wir haben eine. Provides the option to dig in certain places. Okay. Ja, das ist jetzt einmal nicht das Problem, was ich häufig habe. Noch ist es ein Spiel, wo ich gedacht hätte, dass ich zu diesem Problem komme. There's still some meat ore in this card. Dig through it. Okay. Meistens ist es bei mir eher umgekehrt, dass ich V-Sync enforcen will und der will's nicht. It's instructions for the cargo elevator. Cargo elevator control. Blasting cap storage, plungers. Both kinds? Tools. Okay. The elevator's closed, and in any case, it's not a people elevator, it's a cargo elevator. Unrefined meat nugget. Okay. Ja, ich glaube, das Spiel ist auch viel aufwendiger, als es erstmal den Anschein hat, weil es doch einen komplettes 3D-Ding ist. Auch wenn es alles sehr simpel ist. Und die haben sich wahrscheinlich einfach null um Optimierung geschert. Blasting Caps. It looks like you're gonna need a crowbar to pry one of the crates open. Okay, dann kommen wir hier wohl erstmal nicht weiter, oder? Ray Tracing Support, ja. Plungers! The sign light though, there's only one kind. Detonating Plunger, okay. Dann können wir das hier nutzen. Fighting against your instinct for self-preservation, you fucked up a plunger and strung it a fair distance away. Press the plunger and nothing happens. You forgot to hook up a plastic cap. Achso, ja, das ist bei dem anderen Ding. Und da brauchen wir dann aber eine Crowbar. It's a toolbox, but it's locked. Pick a lock. Ach, ein Glück können wir das aufmachen. Ich wollte ihm ja schon eine Nadel geben. Das wäre die letzte gewesen für Dynamit. But the needle is ruined in the process. Most of the tools inside are rusted away to nothing, but there's a pretty nice crowbar. Achso, ja, jetzt wieder eins. You pry one of the crates open with your crowbar and grab a blasting cap. You've succeeded in putting yourself in grave danger. Kaboom! Da ist das Pferd! You see the dark horse, barely. Approach her. Hey there, girl. It's okay. I'm a friend. Winnie? The horse shies away from you. Through in this case, it's more like cripplingly introverted away from you. Reassure her? Aw, oh, come on, don't be like that. Look, I brought some oats for you. They aren't poison or anything. In retrospect, I guess that wasn't a very comforting thing to say. Feed her the oats? Pat her on the nose? Eh. Take a handful of oats out of the bag and hold them out to the horse. Here you go, yum yum. Snort. She sidles away from you warily and makes a surprisingly good attempt at hiding in her own shadow. Come on, please. Put on the nose. Reach out to pert her nose, the horse ducks and steps further into the shadows. Oh, come on! Eat the oats yourself. Look, they're fine, okay? See? Take a handful from the bag and toss some in your mouth. Ouch. It's like the roughest, blandest breakfast cereal you've ever eaten. Still, it's better than dry cat food. Don't ask. You smile to show the horse that you're fine and realize that you've unconsciously turned around and walked out the door. Jeez, these are powerful. Das sind halt so verzauberte Dinger, die einen anscheinend dazu bewegen, zurück zu dem Typen, der uns den Auftrag gegeben hat, zu kommen. The horse looks at you warily as you re-enter with a cheerful wave. See? Perfectly fine. Feed the oats. Okay, geht weiter nicht. But she doesn't actually flee, so that's something. The horse finally seems relaxed enough around you, so you offer her a handful of her oats. Barely, begrudgingly, she eats them. Then she gestures at something behind you. You turn around to look, but don't see anything. When you turn back, she's gone. Okay. What's this crack? Someone's a hole? Ah, wir können hier Dynamit machen, haben wir euch drei. Bend down, shine your lantern into a crack in the rock. You can just barely make out a square shape down in there. Well, out of arm's reach. Wir könnten, hätten drei tauschen können, wenn wir alle Nadeln noch behalten hätten. If you're truly desperate to find out what's in there, you should try reasoning with a rock. The primary argument would be a bundle of dynamite. Perhaps you should persuade the hole to widen enough to grab the box. Okay, hier können wir graben. Ein Silver Nugget. Und mehr Meat. Shiny Nugget of Silver. Hier glaube ich mal durch. Dann erstmal wieder zurück. Haben wir was gefunden? Wir können zumindest mal kurz gucken, ob die das Pferd angekommen ist. Ja! Jetzt können wir schon ein Pferd kaufen. Na, wir machen natürlich jetzt die anderen Quests noch. Boring Springs Boneyard. Zephaniah Boring. He was actually a really interesting guy. Benjamin Crockett. Showed up way too early. Beauregard Skelton. Ach, ja klar, können wir ausgreifen. Ausgraben, angreifen. Ich mach's wie letzte Male auch. Ich beschwöre meine Schlange und schieß dann. Ui, Damage. XP. Put a stop to Captain Skeleton's unnatural animation. Glamour level 3. Old cavalry saber. Here comes the cavalry saber. Und einen Goldzahlen. This was in the ground for a very long time. Then in somebody's mouth for a very short time. And now it's in your backpack. Sweet. Goblin Tan. Nee. Inventar will ich. Dann können wir nämlich den Säbel ausrüsten. Ach, Crowbar können wir auch benutzen als Waffe. 5 bis 6. Crowbar is one of nature's simplest machines. It's exactly what you want on your side if a thing has a lid and you don't want it to have a lid anymore. Hey Skeleton, you're not getting past it without a scuffle. A scuffle it is. Ja, wie immer. Ein weißes Pferd. Spooky translucent horse. You approach the weird semi-transparent horse cautiously so as to not startle her, though you quickly come to the realization that this is not a horse that startles easily. Hello there, hi, I'm a friend, okay? Yay! That's a little strange how you did that without opening your mouth. Put her on the note. You pet the horse's nose, which is very cold. If you were going to ride her, you would want an extra saddle blanket to keep your butt from freezing. Pet on the nose again. Yup, still cold. Brr. You get the idea. Future the oats. Here you go, have some oats. You hold out a handful of oats for the horse. But she just sort of stares right through you. Brr. Please don't look at me like that. You hold the oats out again, but the horse continues to ignore them. What's the matter? Are they not spooky enough? I'm not sure how to make oats spooky. I guess I could put some bone meal on them, but I don't have anything handy to grind up bones with. Grave dirt? That a yes? Weird? Okay. Add some grave dirt to the oats. Sprinkle the oats with just a little bit of grave dirt and hold them out again. The horse gazes expressionlessly at them, then eats them. And with that, she glides away in the direction of town. Bizarre. Timothy Cochrane, devoted husband. Elizabeth Cochrane, beloved daughter. 8 Jahre alt geworden. Phyllis Cochrane, a baby. Ach du Scheiße. Kann man nach den Cochranes dann noch fragen? Ach hier, das ist auch einer, ne? Hey, Crockett, nicht Cochrane. Na gut, dann haben wir noch einen Ort übrig. One of these rocks is really shiny. Grab it. Got an item. Shiny rock. It's shiny and it's about the size of a rock. The snake looks sleepy, but not that sleepy. Take it. Schlange gegen Schlange. Au! You've slain a snake. Before long, they'll call you Snake Murder and Catherine. Wow, they are quick! Aber ich glaube, wir sind vergiftet. Ja, Schlange finde ich eigentlich immer cooler. Auch wenn sie ignoriert wird. made short work of that long snake. Sind wir jetzt weiterhin vergiftet oder ist es dann sofort wieder weg? Scheint dann direkt wieder weg zu sein. An angry rattlesnake. Das ist ganz schön knapp. Skill up, muscle level 2. Nice work. As the whole cowgirl thing doesn't work out, you could always get a job as a snake exterminator. Yup. This horse has gone snake crazy. Or maybe he was some other kind of crazy before. Hey there, boy. Hey, fella. I'm a friend, okay? It's cool, right? Be cool. Don't freak out on me. Look him in the eyes. You calmly look the horse in the eyes. One of them is fixed in a glassy 1,000-yard stare, and the other is revolving madly in its socket like he's thinking of trying to escape in every direction simultaneously. He looks to be calming down a little now, that it's clear you aren't actually made of spiders, though. Nose. You carefully and gently pat the horse's nose. He twitches a bit. Okay, a lot. But seems to recognize that you aren't going to eat his eyes or suck out his soul or whatever madness is bouncing around in that skull of his. That's a good boy. Feed him the oats. Are you hungry, boy? I've got a little treat for you. He feeds the crazy horse some of the homing oats and gallops away with a whinny. Or rather, oh god. Hopefully he's headed home and not into the 12th dimension. Cool. Mostly scabs. Ach so, weil ich mich immer an den Tänen steche. Weil ein Perk bekomme. You've been poked by so many cactuses that your body has built up an entire extra set of skin capillaries just to deal with the constant tiny puncture wounds. Das ist 5 HP. Und 5 HP ist hier richtig viel, ne? Wir hatten 20 bisher. Dann sind wir hier durch. So, was haben wir denn alles? Eigentlich können wir überall nochmal fragen, ob die noch was brauchen. Shovel it. Ach, jetzt können wir die Kacke hier wegmachen. It's nasty work, but somebody gotta do it. Und kriegen jeweils einen Erfahrungspunkt. Looks like my pale horse made it back safe. Thanks for your help. Anytime. Thanks for finding my crazy horse. He was eating loco weed again, wasn't he? That I noticed. That's all of them. I can't thank you enough. Here's a little extra for you. Okay, wir kaufen aber noch kein Pferd. Ich nehme mal an, dann geht's nämlich weiter. Nochmal an die Bar. Ah, vielleicht können wir an denen jetzt einen Whisky verkaufen. Ach nee, Pete notices a shiny rock you're carrying and his wild eyes light up. I give you 7 meat for that rock. 7? Na gut. Pete notices a nugget of silver you found earlier. 81 meat. Okay. Squints and points at the unrefined meat ore you're carrying.
73. Okay.
Pete's eyes narrow as the gears in his head start to click. He fixes his gaze on you and the tick in his eyelids seem more pronounced. Listen, kid. All the stuff what I've been buying from you. You've been spending time underground, ain't ya? Well, you listen to old Pete's advice. You'll stay out of our hole if you know what's good for ya. There's stuff down on the 40th level that ain't worth messing with for a gal wants to keep her eyes, if you catch my meaning. Nee, aber danke.
Mehr ist hier nicht, ne?
Okay. Are you Susie Cochrane? Ah! How do you know my last name? I saw the graves in the cemetery. Sorry for your loss. Susie scowls bitterly and mutters into her whiskey. I saw it happen. Saw the whole damn thing and couldn't do nothing about it. The bartender said it was cows? Cows, right? I don't know what those things are, but they aren't cows. Not anymore. What happened? Was a raid. See, Ma and Pa used to ranch cattle back before. Well, before they came home. Pa didn't make it, but Ma and I managed to rebuild. We ranched pigs instead, and she left me as a place when she passed. Well, I guess the passing herd sniffed out that it used to be a cow ranch and they attacked. Couple days ago. Happened so fast. I didn't even have time to get my rifle out of the gun safe. Cow smashed in the front door and fire started out back by the root cellar. House went up in a blaze. Just like that.
Did you do?
There wasn't anything I could do. Couldn't get upstairs to the kid. Caused the fire and I saw Tim trampled right in front of me. She drains her glass. I ain't wanna talk about it anymore. What do you will do now? Head west, suppose. Nothing keeping me here and no desire to stay. Can't leave without my rifle, though. Why not? It was Ma's rifle. It's all I got left of. Anybody. Where is it? Left it at the ranch like a damn fool. Listen, can I ask you a favor? I need someone to get for me. Klar? New map location? The Cochrane Ranch.
So, jetzt noch was Neues.
Ich habe das Gefühl, es sind so viele versteckte Dinge mit den verschiedenen Perks und so weiter.
Wie kriege ich dauernd die Meldung? Willkommen im Chat, anscheinend reconnected irgendwie Twitch immer.
Sehr strange.
Okay, können wir erstmal nichts weiter traden. Was ist mit ihr? Moment.
Ach so, jetzt haben wir quasi erzählt, dass wir die auch gesehen haben, die Untoten. Und dann, it's nice to get some outside confirmation that I'm not losing my damn mind. But how is that even possible? It isn't possible. It goes against everything I know about medicine. Dead patients don't get back up. Patients? Oh, ouch. Doc Ellis turns away, grimacing. Every doctor loses one now and again, and never get used to it, but, well, it happens. But what doesn't happen is them coming back afterwards and looking for revenge. That must be pretty rough. Rough? Missy, I don't think you comprehend the situation. It's not just patients, it's neighbors, friends, husbands. Indeed. She turns away from you and focuses her attention back to the bottle. Do you have any idea what's causing the resurrections? I heard a rumor. A rumor? What is it? It's when you get incomplete information from an unverified source. Anyway, what I heard is that there's a fella out west that's causing it, a necromancer they call him, supposedly sending magic out into the world somehow. Magic like the beanslingers use? I never heard of any beanslinger raising the dead, have you? A skull deepens. That'd be one hell of a can of beans. Ja, jetzt fragen wir nach dem Dynamit. Vielleicht nach beidem. It's so, when I feel like I'm about to go, I can blow myself into bits too small, so small there won't be nothing left to come back. That seems drastic. Drastic? Hell, no way I'm taking the risk of becoming one of those things. What's a necromancer? Assuming he exists, what about him? Well, maybe someone ought to try and stop him? You? Because I know you ain't talking about me. Why not? A gray-haired old woman that knows as much about fighting as a squirrel knows surgery? Did you hit your head on a barstool, kid? You aren't that old. Jetzt überreden wir die, die Quest selbst zu machen. You aren't that old. And if I were gonna pick someone to go up against a necromancer, I'd be someone who also knows about death, but in a scientific way. A doctor, right? Doc Ellis stares at you and takes a swig from a bottle, saying nothing. And it sounds to me like you've got plenty of motivation to get the job done, for your friends and everyone. She continues to look at you. You can see the gears turning in her head. It beats doing nothing anyway. Beats locking yourself in a house full of TNT and drinking yourself to death. You aren't even doing any doctoring anymore. She winces and looks away. Then she shakes her head slowly. You seriously expect me to ride out west by myself chasing a rumor? Doesn't have to be by yourself. I'm heading west too. Tag along with me and maybe we can find the guy and put a stop to him. It's crazy. Impossible. Impossible like raising the dead is impossible? Alice crosses her arms and regards you thoughtfully. Spark slowly brightens her eyes. Alright, kid. What the hell? Let's give it a shot. Cool. Just let me know when you're ready to leave. I wait here. So, dann gehen wir zu der Ranch. Susie's ranch house has burned to the ground. Something behind the store is making some pretty awful noises. Looks like somebody was in the middle of fixing a knife. Ramen skinning knife. Allows you to collect skins from beasts after combat. Uh-huh. Oh god. The thing looks angry. You're not gonna make it to that safe without dealing with it. Deal with it. Na dann, so wie jedes Mal. Ui. We defeated the nasty cow skull floating in a cloud of flame. It's the Crossrain family's gun safe. Grab Susie's rifle. Got an item, Susie's rifle. It's an old rifle, but it's obviously been well cared for. There are six little notches carved into the stock. These pies were not safe. Wir hatten am Anfang in unserem Wohnhaus einen Schrank, wo sie sagte, dieser, ja, naja, halt, hier hält unsere Mutter die Kuchen sicher vor uns. Jetzt halt hier. Dieser Schrank hält die Kuchen nicht sicher. So, haben wir noch was gefunden, wo wir vielleicht nochmal irgendwie zurück müssen oder so nochmal? Ja, was ist denn eigentlich mit diesem Goldzahn? Wir haben so viele Stranger Items. Was ist mit ihm eigentlich hier? Find my rifle yet, stranger? Yep, here she is. Susie's eyes well up with tears as you hand her the rifle, and she roughly scrubs her sleeve across her face before any of them spill over. Thanks, stranger. I didn't catch your name? Catherine. Thanks, Catherine. Can't rightly say what this means to me. She looks at the rifle for a long moment, then looks back at you. She sighs. Well, that's enough wallowing in misery. Time for me to hit the road. If you want me to tag along when you head west, just say the word. Okay, also wir haben jetzt schon mehrere Personen, die im Grunde mit wollen, sobald wir ein Pferd haben. So, dann würde ich sagen, mache ich jetzt hier eine kurze Pause. Und dann reiten wir gleich nach Westen. Bis gleich. So, da bin ich wieder. Ich habe gerade festgestellt, dass wir extrem viel... Ich werde gerade von der Seite angequatscht. So, nee, da bin ich wieder. Gerade festgestellt, dass wir extrem viel Hafermilch verbrauchen. Unfassbare Mengen. Und halt für hauptsächlich für Frühstück. Und das normalerweise, frühstücken wir halt nicht. Hat sich jetzt doch ganz schön geändert. Glaubt man gar nicht, wie unterschiedlich der Verbrauch dann auf einmal sein kann. So, dann kaufen wir uns jetzt ein Pferd. Sure thing, I should have warned you though. Horses are mighty attached. Genau, wir können uns nicht nochmal umentscheiden. Was war mit Frühstück? Nee, ich meinte nur, dass durch die Umstände, dass wir jetzt beide von zu Hause arbeiten, dass wir unglaublich viel Milch verbrauchen. Und, also wirklich absurde Mengen. Wir haben letztens beim Einkaufen, wir wollen immer so gucken, dass es für eine Woche reicht. Wir haben 4 Liter gekauft und es wird ganz schön knapp. So, jetzt müssen wir uns überlegen, ob wir ein normales Pferd nehmen. Shifty Looking Dark One, Spooky Pale One oder Crazy Eyes. Der Crazy Eyes macht mich verrückt. Wir nehmen den Dark One. Finde ich cool. Jeden Tag Müsli. Na, wir haben gar nicht mal so viel. Wir trinken halt relativ viel Milch in Kaffee. Wir trinken jeden Tag zu zweit eine Kanne. Und wir machen bestimmt zweimal die Woche irgendwas zu essen mit Milch. Also entweder einen Haferbrei oder Eierkuchen oder sowas. Aber das ist es eigentlich. Und wir haben jetzt letzte Woche, ich glaube Dienstag oder Mittwoch, 4 Liter gekauft. Das ist jetzt schon wieder demnächst allem. Takes a shifty looking dark one. Good choice. She's a sneaky one. I'll sell her for 1000 Fleisch. Can you say sneaky? Well, she's real quiet, and she likes dark places. I remember. And just look how she's trying to hide behind the other horse there. Seems pretty smart, I'll take her. Here's the keys, right safe. Give her a name. Tina? Ja, meinetwegen heißt sie Tina. Ich habe keine Ahnung, wie wir unser Pferd nennen sollen. Tina the horse. It's got a nice ring to it. Haferschleim. Nee, es wird gar nicht so ein Schleim. Ich weiß gar nicht genau. Nee, es ist eher so ein Brei. Mit Früchten? Vielleicht ist es aber auch genau das. Ich weiß es nicht, aber eigentlich ist doch nochmal so Porridge-Zeug ist nochmal was anderes, oder? Was wäre doch denn so Haferschleim? Nee, aber es ist kein Müsli. Es ist schon dann heiß gemacht im Topf. Aber zum Frühstück. Almost forgot. Free with every horse purchase is a complimentary map. Genau. Southwest map. Follow map to dirt water. You have to fill the bike to... Eine leere Karte, die man selber ausfüllen darf. Schön. Genau, es ist im Grunde wie ein Grießbrei. Nur mit Hafer. Glaube ich. Weiß nicht. Sie bereitet das immer zu. Ich krieg's nur vorgesetzt. So, ich weiß nicht genau, wie wir das jetzt machen mit Heading West. Ich dachte, wir sagen jetzt den Leuten nochmal Bescheid, dass sie mit sollen. Aber die sagen nicht, sondern die sagen nur... Ja, wenn du nach Westen reitest, dann komme ich mit. Once you leave Boring Springs, you won't be able to come back. Any unfinished business you've got will forever remain unfinished. Oh, ich weiß es doch nicht. Das finde ich jetzt aber gemein. Und was muss doch mit diesem Goldzahn noch sein? Ich will hier nochmal durchlaufen. Hier können wir nicht... Das können wir nicht harvesten, weil wir haben nicht Foragen. Es kann aber auch sein, dass es dann dass nur Leute mit einer anderen Klasse das können oder so. Man kann sich am Anfang zwischen drei Klassen entscheiden. Ans Klavier. Na dann, viel Spaß. Hier fehlt uns das Dynamit. Wir können ihm Dynamit nicht einfach... Können nicht einfach belabern und dann Dynamit kriegen. Ach ja, hier Level 40, das hatte ja einer erzählt. Ah. Stimmt. It's a strange black chest. Open the chest. A wave of nausea hits you when you slice the heavy lid off the chest. Inside there is a head. It looks evil. And not in an abstract way. It has eyes, and they look like the eyes of a murderer. And has teeth, which look like the teeth of an animal who would be a murderer if animals understood the concept of murder. Put it on. Oh nein, hard mode! Yeah, you have a sense of foreboding. Something tells you this is a bad idea. It's me. I'm telling you this is a bad idea. If you put this head on, you won't ever be able to take it off, and things will be much harder for you. It will be as tough your life as a game, and that game's difficulty level is greatly increased if you catch my meaning. You also get the sense that your extremely shy horse will not be willing to travel with you if you're wearing that head. You'll need to swap for another one at the hostel before you can leave Boring Springs. Aber wenn ich das swappen kann beim Hostel. Ach so, ich muss das Pferd tauschen und nicht den Hut. Nee. Something tells you this is a bad idea. It's me! I tell you this is a bad idea. Finde ich sehr gut. Und ich habe echt das Gefühl, dass da Leute... Dadurch, dass die Technik und so simpel ist, einfach viel mehr Zeit hatten, sich kreative Dinge auszudenken. Und man kann natürlich Dinge dann auch, wenn man irgendeine komische Idee hat, das kann man natürlich bei sowas auch super schnell umsetzen und muss sich nicht überlegen, oh Gott, ja, das ist irgendwie dann eine schwierige Animation und da müssen wir dann irgendwie ewig dran arbeiten. Und weiß ich nicht, kann die Engine dieses und jenes, sondern ist einfach so. Alles so hingemalt. Funktioniert aber deswegen sehr, sehr gut. Na gut, dann gehen wir jetzt. Are you ready to leave? Alright then. You're probably horsed and ready to start your new life in the West. All you need now is a partner. Somebody to share the trail with. Somebody you can rely on for emotional combat support. Crazy Pete, Doc Ellis, Susie Cotrain. Go it alone, not recommended. Ich finde ja Susie eigentlich am spannendsten und die hat jetzt das coole Gewehr. Wobei ich das auch irgendwie lustig finde, mit Frau Ellis diesen Necromancer zu jagen. You pop back to the saloon and collect Susie. Hit the trail. One last thing before you go. Up until this point, I've been automatically spending your experience points for you. I'm happy to keep doing it and I promise to give you a nice, well-rounded experience. Shall I keep it up? Or would you prefer to decide for yourself where your XP gets spent? You can always change this later. Ja, wenn die Macher das für eine gute Idee halten, wenn dass sie das übernehmen, dann lassen wir es so. You consult the southeast-west map the hostler gave you. It only lists two things: the town of Dirtwater and the Manifest Destiny Railroad Company's westernmost camp. At for Dirtwater, day one, the first day of the rest of your life. Yeah, here you see, Compermain. She whinnies shyly. So, jetzt können wir Horse Armor an. Achso, genau, das ist. Buggies steht ja hier. Das ist weg. It's your partner. What's new, Susie? I'd like to check up on some of the ranches in these parts. See how bad the cow attack's getting. Do you know some? Not in great detail, but I know roughly where a few are. Or at least where. Guess we just have to see. There's one not far from here. What do you think we should do next? If we are looking to get a move on westward, I reckon a train's the way to go. Didn't the maps the hostler gave you have a marker on some railroad camp or other? Might be worth checking out. Können wir nach oben? Den kann man irgendwie nicht quatschen, die hier vorbeilaufen. Sie sieht wütend aus. Dann gehen wir auch hier mal so durch von Haus zu Haus. These guys having a spirited discussion about guns and which of theirs is nice. Hey, how come they're allowed to drink without hats on? Stage. Cowbell. Hit it. Ach, irgendwie war ich mir sicher, dass was passiert, wenn man auf genug drückt. This chair fell over. Set it back up. Here we go, 1 XP. There's a sign that says, see bartender for darts. The man points to the sign on the counter. 5 meat by some slop. Got a item. Also wir können hier Slop kaufen. Increase the maximum XP for the rest of the day. They should really hire better kitchen staff before some competing restaurant moves in and eats their lunch. This lady is too busy washing dishes to pay attention to you. This is where the chef preps ingredients for cooking. It's also where he parks his beer. Tops his potbelly stove is a pot full of slop. A pot stove top slop pot. Hey, what are you doing here? Employees only, bud. Oh, sorry, I was just, looking around. So you're the nosy type, eh? Well, I prefer adventuresome. As it happens, there's something you can do for me. I'm out of salt, Peter. I need someone to go pick up. Oh, okay. That used to make gunpowder and other things. Look, who's the chef here, me or you? Okay, where can I find it? Where's the military camp? Because it's used to make gunpowder. Shut up! The nearest town is for cowardice. They keep it in a little green jars. Slop helper. Not very good at this job. Okay. Stares off into the distance, listening to the piano. Try to talk to him. He doesn't react to you at all. Rules of poker, followed by 100 of weird rules in tiny print. Threes are wild unless accompanied by 3 one-armed jacks. Players spitting anywhere other than a spittoon must immediately discard 3 queens. One-armed jacks are wild unless accompanied by 3 sixes of heart. A full house beats a Mexican straight. Play poker. Einen Moment. You sit down on the poker table, a dealer emerges from somewhere in the back and sits down next to you. The lady to your right introduces herself as Sal, and the player to your left says his name is Paco. The dealer tells you that ante is 20 meat. Ante up. God. The dealer gives the deck a shuffle and then deals. A hand of cards glides across the table to you. It's a totally garbage hand. A 9 of diamonds, a 10... and 2 two-eyed kings of clubs. The first round, the pot is 60 meat in your estimate. Your chance of winning at around 10%. Glamorously rise. Moxiously strategize. Ja, das können wir nur bluffen, oder? Wir raisen. With a flourish, you plop 20 more meat down in front of you. Second round of betting, the pot is 120 meat and you estimate your chance of winning around 10%. Na, dann wird nochmal graced. Und wir raisen wieder. You frown and reveal a full house. Zell sighs and reveals a hand, a full house. Paco turns over a straight. You win! Ante has been raised to 25. It's a terrible hand, a 4. Achso, jetzt brauchen wir nochmal höhere Stats, okay. Sie raisen wieder. Achso, ein Check erhöht die Win-Chance auf 20%, um 10%. Ach Gott. In Nevada Flash. Das ist ja verrückt, ey. It's a really great hand. 3 fives, 2 sixes and 4 one-armed queens of diamonds. It's the first round. Round 40%. Check. Ja, ich weiß aber dann nicht, was die anderen genau machen. Ob dann Check eigentlich am besten ist jeweils? You grin and reveal your hand, a straight. Zell shrugs as reveals a Kentucky flush. Paco flips his cards over one at a time, revealing a backwards Georgia flush. Boo. Ah, strategize. You arrange your cards into a more aesthetically pleasing spread, plus 20% wood chunks. Ah, es macht anscheinend immer plus 20% mit Strategize. Okay, es reicht aber nicht, wir verlieren trotzdem. Na gut, wir haben viel Kohle verloren. Sind raus. Oh nein, das ist Betun. That people spit into instead of spitting on the floor, because not spitting at all is not an option in this society, I guess. I say this despite knowing that you're pretty intimately familiar with spittoons already, sicko. Inspected. Look, the jewel saloon is pretty nice, the saloons go. Actual glass in the windows, more than two kinds of drinks, a poker room instead of a cockfighting pit. But this spittoon is still a spittoon. The rancid tobacco spit inside it isn't fancy rancid tobacco spit. Sigh, here we go again. Alright, fine, you're no hunkered down next to a brass filth bucket which has probably never been cleaned or emptied because you're near the desert and ambient humidity around here is pretty low. Low enough that the spit evaporates nearly as quickly as it accumulates. That's good, right? No, that's bad, because it's only the water part of spit that evaporates. This brass bucket is half full of the rest of the spit, the toxins and filth that don't evaporate, several years worth, distilled and concentrated until it consists of molasses. People aren't allowed to flick cigarette butts into the spittoon anymore because they bounce out. Search it. You're about to put your hand into a bucket of something the color and viscosity of maple syrup, except instead of maple it's flavored with the inside of the mouth of people and chew cigars instead of smoking them and have never brushed their teeth. Yeah. Glob. It feels like putting your hand into a bucket of lukewarm tapioca pudding, except instead of tapioca it's basically poison. It smells like someone ran over a skunk, waited a week and then set it on fire. It feels like your hand is dissolving. Keep searching. God. You found something. You found a tacky, filth-covered porcelain cow figurine. A useless, disgusting thing that will make a great heirloom for your children, assuming they're still able to have any, and you hate them. Plus 3 Attack Damage, plus 3 Spell Damage. This item goes into your offhand. Hooray! Doesn't look like he's in the mood to talk. Oh, it's nice to see a new face in town. Welcome to Jules' Saloon. Catherine? Call me Lloyd? Ach Gott, ich habe letztens gehört, wie man das richtig ausspricht. Cloyd? T vorne? Wenn das so ein Doppel-L ist? Cloyd? To meet you, Cloyd? Shot of bourbon? The old man by the piano? Advertising a room? For a partner too, how much does it cost? Month in advance, right before getting yourself killed by bandits, it seemed like a decent sort. So the rooms, yours if you want it gratis. Great. Okay. Well, if you're handy with mechanical type stuff, someone's going wrong with our piano. Piano player. Thought the music sounded a little off. What I can do. I lost the key. Nee, ist nicht, ne? Try to fix them. Okay, brauchen wir wieder eine Nadel. Oder den Schlüssel. Was a writer and a poet came out west to sell stories, but nobody were buying. Too weird stories. Fantastical like. Well, it don't matter much now anyhow. He had to get normal work to make ends meet, did passing well as a prospector, until one day he lost his mind in a mind. What now? You know what I mean. He saw something. Something that made him stop telling his weird tales. Made him stop talking near completely, come to that. He just stands there by the piano nowadays. Seems to calm down as long as he doesn't make any trouble. I don't mind him too much. Feel a little sorry for him, to be honest. All the darts got broken a month ago. Schade. Ein Bourbon. Famous dirt water bourbon, which is famous mostly for having visible chunks of dirt in it. Gott, ist das riesig. Hey Susie, what do you think of this place? Alright, sounds a bit busy for my taste, but a change makes a change from being on the road. But wash the dust off once a while, right? Ah, yep. Go back, collect some fresh new dust. These guys must have fallen asleep during a brawl. Ach, unser Raum, okay.
Können wir schlafen? Postcard. Blank Postcard. Maybe you should write to your family back home in case you don't know how the mail works. You send these by going to the building called the post office, given to the correspondence wizard who works there. You look inside yourself. Call yourself a green-bellied, floor-flushing jerk. You can in effect angry. You better not insult yourself anymore. Get any angrier, you're liable to pass out. Have O's and it's angry. Ist das nicht wieder ein Perk oder so? Oder check ich das irgendwie nicht? Achso, waren wir schon? Dann sind wir hier, glaube ich, durch, oder? Selling flowers, buy some sweet smelling flowers. Smell really good. 50% stench resistance. Ah. Ah, wir haben das schon als Offhand. Das ist ziemlich gut. Ach, hier kann man jetzt wirklich mal Kram kaufen, verkaufen. Ach so, your stuff, das ist for sale. Okay, jetzt. Cover new map location, you can find a high vantage point. Ah, hier haben wir jetzt Dynamit. Learn a new snake oiling skill? Schaufel haben wir. Ich weiß leider nicht, ob wir die auch an irgendeiner Stelle mal brauchen, um irgendwo weiterzukommen oder so wie es Dynamit, dass man das irgendwie im Kampf nutzen kann, aber auch woanders. Ich kaufe mal sicherheitshalber welche davon. Oh Gott, jetzt habe ich mehr Zeugs gekauft, nur davon gab es nur eins. Naja, solange wir nicht irgendwas richtig Teures gekauft haben, passt schon. Hier! Angry! Ah, hier so Status... Meldung, okay.
Ja. Ach, war denn zwar nur sehr kurzer Stream, aber ich würde, glaube ich, gerne Schluss machen, weil ich sehr hungrig bin. Und mal gucken, vielleicht machen wir nachher schon noch weiter. Und wenn nicht, dann wahrscheinlich morgen. Na gut, dann vielen Dank fürs Zusehen. Habt noch einen schönen Nachmittag, einen schönen Abend. Und ja, wir sehen uns. Bis dann. Tschüss.